So the crowd are getting ready to see the 20 athletes that will take to the slopes very shortly. And those 20, it will go down to 12, then 12 to 6, and those final 6 will ski for the Olympic medals. Seeking a spot in the final. 12, Cooper Woods Topolovich, a 21-year-old from New South Wales. One top 10 this season, 76.74 in his qualification run.
And a beautiful position on that top air, so the back full and keeping his legs and body line completely straight in the air. Moving very fast through this middle section and down into the bottom jump, going huge for a Cork 720. You see down here the Cork 720 getting those arms up on the landing, so two great jumps here.
77.58 for Cooper Woods Topolovich. He seems pleased, he should be. He's in second place. Miko Kingsbury of Canada begins his campaign for gold medal number 2.
Mikael showing us exactly why he has that number 1 bib, going huge on that top air and then keeping those turns so tight here in the middle section of the course. Known for his airs, going for the 1080 on the bottom. That is a great first run here in the final. Yeah, Mikael knows that consistency is exactly what the judges need here in order to go round to round and not get eliminated.
Does it with ease, 81.78, and takes his first round in this Moguls final. So here is confirmation of the first round in this men's Moguls final. The top 12 will advance. Miko Kingsbury, Sugimoto Kosuke, Haradachi, Walter Wahlberg, Horishima Ikuma, Benjamin Kaveh, Cooper Woods Topolovich, Nikita Andreev, Dmitry Rikard, the veteran, Nick Page of the USA. Those 10 advance along with Sasha Theocharis and Brody Summers. We begin round 2. Brody Summers, the 28-year-old from Melbourne, Australia, making the most of his run here in Beijing.
And Brody is bringing it here in the finals. So big jump on that top one, a back full, great extension and great landing into the middle section of the course here. Keeping those arms and eyes up into the bottom air for a corked out 720. This is a great consistent run. Yeah, you see the extension here on this back full. So great line and form in the body.
75 points dead for Brody Summers. Pointing a bit shy of his previous score, Cooper Woods Topolovich from New South Wales. Been in decent form this season. The top 10 to his name. First run in the Olympics.
And a great top air, so the back full with great extension and then using that speed here in the middle section of the course. As I said, consistency is key, so going huge on the bottom air and a great landing. Great run here for this athlete. And then the turns here in the middle section, showing the judges he's got control of those knees and those feet underneath him. So really want to be in control of those skis throughout the entire course.
Does he get the reward for it? He certainly does. 77.22 for Cooper Woods Topolovich. He takes the lead in the second round. Skiing since the age of 2, 4 top 10s this season for the former Rookie of the Year. Starting out on this second run, seeking for a place in the final.
And Walter using that momentum from that previous round on that top air and then flying through this middle section of the course. Very quick to keep up with these moguls. And wrapping up the 1080 on the bottom there. That was executed great. With his chest and those arms ready and ready to ski down the rest of the course. It's extremely difficult to get back into the moguls as clean as Walter just did.
77.22 the target. He's through to ski for the Olympic gold. 80.33 for Walter Wahlberg, and he goes into first place. Kingsbury. 23 World Cup starts. He's found one podium as he goes for an Olympic medal here in Beijing.
And a great trick to start. So grabbing that ski, having some style points in the top of the course. The momentum here in the middle is crucial as you get into this bottom section. Going huge, the cork 1080 lands in a great position here in the finals.
What a start to this final round. Nick Page of the United States.
I know it might be a little slow on the time, but the turns were tight and consistent. And then wrapping up the 1080 on the bottom air and landing almost perfect. So those arms are in a great position, ready to ski away. You can see his teammates are very excited on the result here.
So the score to set. It's 78.9 for Nick Page, one of the best scores that he's achieved. Cooper Woods, Topolovich, what a competition he has had. This, whatever happens, will be his best ever result in a moguls competition. How high can he go?
And Cooper having great form on that top air, going enormous with a back full, and then using that momentum here into the middle section of the course. Taking a breath before this bottom air, going huge with a big cork 720, another great run.
Absolutely thrilled.
And then using the turns in this middle section to show the judges that he's got control, keeping those knees together, possibly some small breaks of form, but great speed and momentum as he makes his way off the bottom jump, going absolutely enormous. Really well done. Picking up that vision on that last rotation is crucial. You need to be ready to ski away across the finish line.
78.9 his target. He's two off it. 78.88 for Cooper Woods Topolovich. We continue this final round with Benjamin Cave. Is it going to be his time? So many near misses for this 28-year-old Frenchman, twice a runner-up in World Championships, here going for gold.
And great form on that top air, so using that speed here in the middle section, skiing very fast here. Keeping the speed up, going for the 1080 on the bottom air, a huge jump.
24.6 seconds, the fastest time in this final round so far.
But then using that momentum, keeping the speed up all the way into this bottom jump, wrapping it up and really showing the judges he wants that degree of difficulty. This is final three here at the Olympics, so you cannot hold back.
And 78.9, the target for the lead. He's got it. 79.44 for Benjamin Cave of France. He has the lead with three athletes to go. Three-time a winner this season. The question is, does he have anything left? He's already skied three times tonight. He may have taken a lot out of him. Horashina Akuma going for an Olympic medal. 79.44 to be on the podium.
And saving it all for this last run, going absolutely so fast in the middle section of the course here. Keeping that speed up and then wrapping up the 1080. Great landing and across the line.
A super quick time, 23.86 seconds.
So fast and such a difficult run that he just put it all together here in the finals.
Like the Olympics, 79.44. Down below. is the target.
This is where he brings it all together. So going for that 1080, an extremely difficult trick, and then skiing away very well.
81.48, Horishima Akuma is guaranteed an Olympic medal. Now, with one gold medal to his name, he seeks one more. The 2018 Olympic champion, looking to go back to back. Here he goes, 81.48, will guarantee him a medal.
And keeping that great back full on the top air right into the middle section, keeping those knees together and trying to keep up with this course. Mikel is so consistent and goes for a big 1080 at the bottom, a great landing.
He thinks he may have just done enough. 25 seconds, 0.02, 81.48 is what he needs to get the lead. If he goes past 79.44, he's going to be on the podium once again.
Yeah, you see the great extension on this top air, so a back full, pinning those legs together, and then a great position to land in as he moves throughout the middle section of the course. The turns here in the middle section were so tight. He's absorbing those moguls, really keeping those skis pinned to the ground and those knees together. This is great skiing, and this is exactly what you need to do if you want to get a gold medal.
For the lead, Mikel Kingsbury is there. 82.18, he has the lead on a couple of hands and fingers, perhaps on another gold medal. Only one man can now beat him. From Sweden, the 21-year-old, Walter Wahlberg, has never won a professional moguls competition at the highest level. He's been on the podium 12 times. He's been second 5 times. Is this his moment to win the greatest prize in men's moguls?
Walter qualified first and going huge on that top air, using those speed points here in the middle section and keeping those turns consistent. Got to keep it together here on the bottom air. Goes for the 1080 and a great landing.
And a very quick time, 23.7 seconds. It's the fastest time we've seen in this final. He's already picked up 16.75 points. This could be close. This could be very tight.
I do not want to be a judge here because Walter's execution on this entire run was great. You see the back full, so a backflip with one full rotation on the top air, a great trick, and then he lands in a ready position for that middle section. So starts turning immediately, and that fall line is very important to the turns and score here.
82.18 is what Walter Wahlberg needs to become the Olympic champion.
And Walter's turns in the middle section were nearly perfect, and turns are 60% of your score, so his airs were great, but the turns were nearly perfect.
82.18 is the target. Is he the champion, or does it go to Kingsbury? We all wait with bated breath. Walter Wahlberg has dethroned the king! 83.23, Walter Wahlberg of Sweden is the Olympic champion. Dylan, your thoughts on what we've seen?
Absolutely amazing skiing from all of the competitors today. They've really brought everything you needed to have in order to get onto the podium here today. So Walter absolutely crushing his last run and getting that gold medal. And then the other two competitors here really just bringing everything they have. Mikel showing up and giving it his all.